Hey y'all, Mandy from My Hectic Life here. So today I wanted to talk to you about a common disease amongst reptile and amphibian owners, and that is metabolic bone disease. Reptiles that eat mostly insects and vegetation are going to be at a high risk for metabolic bone disease. Metabolic bone disease is primarily caused by a lack of calcium and vitamin D in your reptile's diet. Typical symptoms that you're going to see on your reptile is going to be bowed legs, problems with their jaw, inability to eat, loss of appetite, and more. If calcium levels are dropping in your pet, you might notice lethargy and you might notice tremors and even seizures in your animal. The main cause of this disease is a lack of vitamin D and a lack of calcium in the diet. Vitamin D3 is extremely important for your reptile to be able to absorb calcium into their system. Without vitamin D3, then they won't be able to absorb the calcium and their blood levels will quickly drop. Metabolic bone disease is usually pretty easy to avoid. Making sure that if you have a pet that needs ultraviolet rays, that you do get a UVB bulb for your reptile can help to manufacture vitamin D in the system. If you have reptiles or amphibians that can't really have a UVB light, it would be too much for them, like my albino Pac-Man frog that cannot have a UVB light. His skin is way too sensitive and he would just end up burying himself in the substrate all day, and so it wouldn't do him any good anyway. So in cases like this, it's really important that you make sure that what you're feeding is calcium and vitamin D3 rich foods. So in the case of animals that only eat pretty much insects, you're going to want to use a vitamin D3 calcium supplement. So I do gut load my crickets. I will put a link to that video somewhere up here, and I will link it in the description below as well. All you're going to be doing is making sure that you're feeding your crickets or roaches a high calcium diet. You can even look up, there are several gut-loading recipes online, but you want to make sure that whatever insects that you're feeding are eating high calcium, vitamin D3 rich foods to also help your reptile get as much balanced nutrition as possible so that you can prevent metabolic bone disease. Now, if you do have an animal that does feed on a lot of vegetation and you need to get calcium-rich foods in there, there are plenty of calcium-rich foods out there such as bok choy, kale, and Brussels sprouts. If you do have a reptile or an animal or amphibian that does need or require a UVB light, please make sure that you do have a UVB light on your tank, and that you are using it and making sure that you are cycling it properly. Most UVBs are recommended to leave on for 8 to 12 hours during the day, and of course turn off at night. So with these tips, it can be really easy to prevent metabolic bone disease. There are a few reptiles that are a little bit more prone to it and require extra care, and sometimes you're unlucky and you get one that just really cannot absorb calcium no matter how much vitamin D3 they get. But with the proper nutrition and proper lighting for your reptile or amphibian, this is typically an easy prevention. So that's all for today's video. If you found this information useful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel where I make videos almost every single day. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye!